Welcome to Dank Ferrick. Today we'll be looking into the one and the only, the chosen one himself, Anakin Skywalker. And in this journey, we're going to look deep inside of him and speak on the truths about his character, about his tragedies. But before we do begin that, toss a like up on this video if you enjoy the content, or subscribe if you're new for more Star Wars videos, which are always right around the corner, right here on Dank Ferrick. Now without anything further, this is the truth, the tragedy of Anakin Skywalker, in the sadness that lived within him. But most of all, the one thing that truly sealed it all in. Attachment. Undeniable, unquestionable attachment. We all know him and his entire story. The boy who came from slavery on Tatooine, the world beneath the twin suns, and eventually became a Jedi Knight, all to one day fall and transform into a Dark Lord of the Sith. But what some don't often look at is the tragedy of what lived within Anakin Skywalker after he left his mother behind on Tatooine. And the truth is that so much of what lived within Anakin was great turmoil, sadness, confliction, and far worse. It certainly aided in his becoming of Darth Vader, but it still was there in his days as a Jedi Knight, and long after he was sworn in as a Sith Lord.
He can see things before they happen. That's why he appears to have such quick reflexes. It's a Jedi trait.
He deserves better than a slave's life.
Had he been born in the Republic, we would have identified him early. The Force is unusually strong with him. That much is clear. Who was his father?
There was no father.
I carried him. I gave birth. I raised him. I can't explain what happened.
And it's as I said before, so much of this truly began the day that he had to leave his mother, Shmi Skywalker, behind. Yes, Anakin was wanting to go with Qui-Gon and become a Jedi Knight, but leaving his mother truly tore at his heart. This woman raised a boy in chains, just as she was bound to the same chains herself. And as Anakin knew this, he was a very aware boy. So leaving her, even if it's to become a guardian of justice and peace in the galaxy and finally return one day, was absolutely gut-wrenching for him. And this is where his struggle with attachment truly began. But with good reason, for Shmi Skywalker was the one and only person he ever loved at this point. The only one he knew love from. Though still, despite the fear of leaving her or the pain it caused, Shmi Skywalker looked upon her son and told him not to look back. She knew a better life could be ahead for him, and as Anakin would try to do just that, his mother would rest upon his thoughts and dreams for countless years to come.
Will I ever see you again?
What does your heart tell you?
I hope so. Yes. I guess.
Then we will see each other again.
I will come back and free you, Mom. I promise.
Love and attachment would be one of the weights upon Anakin Skywalker after leaving Tatooine. He trained and trained to become a Jedi under Obi-Wan Kenobi, but his thoughts leaned upon those he loved and deeply cared for, often betraying him. This, of course, always kept him from becoming the Jedi he should be, that he wanted to be, that others expected him to be. However, this truly came into fruition in his later years as a Jedi Padawan. The death of his mother by the Tusken Raiders would split his spirit to the bone. Already struggling with where he was at as a Jedi, finding his mother taken and destroyed by the Sand People was a struggle Anakin would never truly overcome.
Why'd she have to die? Why couldn't I save her? I know I could have.
Sometimes there are things no one can fix. You're not all powerful.
Well, I should be. Someday I will be. I will be the most powerful Jedi ever.
all of this emotional torment was one of the larger steps toward the dark side of the Force for Anakin, even if he was dubbed as the chosen one to one day bring balance to the Force. With this echo of pain lurking deep within his soul and often rearing its ugly head, Anakin Skywalker would soon find love again. With its painful loss of his mother, a new attachment was born, just like a tree planted above graves that grew large and strong. An attachment that brought the tragedy of Anakin Skywalker even further. One that, just like the love that it sprouted from, would stand strong across the stars.
You love me? I thought that we had decided not to fall in love. That we would be forced to live a lie. And that it would destroy our lives.
I think our lives are about to be destroyed anyway.
It was true love. Padme Amidala and Anakin Skywalker holding it, they came to flourish as a couple. Their love was a deep, dark, and intimate secret that stretched across their lives. One that struck against the core pillars of the Jedi Order. It was a love that could very easily push Anakin toward the darker side of the Force, even if he only felt good feelings from it. And sadly, such would be the case for our hero. Though as for their forbidden love, he had to hide this, from start to middle, and nearly all of the way to the end. Each true conversation the two of them had was hidden and secretive. Their relationship was never as a relationship is truly meant to be. All of the risk Anakin had of being expelled from the Jedi Order. So as Anakin worked to be a husband for his beloved wife, he was also lying to the very order that he was sworn to, and he was trying to become a member of. So as he thought he was doing good for both sides, being a guardian of peace and justice, and also embracing Padme, he was truly tarnishing both, even if his intent was never ill.
You were so beautiful.
It's only because I'm so in love.
No, no, it's because I'm so in love with you.
So love has blinded you?
Well, that's not exactly what I meant.
Through this, their forbidden love would last years and survive through the Clone Wars themselves, as Anakin eventually reached the rank of Jedi Knight. But it's in all of these years that the love they had also brought Anakin pain once more, and this time, he would chase it. He would try to chase it away, but to do so, he had to follow it all the way into the cave that it dwelled within, deep inside of him. You see, he loved his mother so much, and the only one he ever came to love more than her was Padme, only to eventually come to feel and see visions just like those that came before. He foresaw his mother's death, and now he foresees Padme's, hoping that like his mother's, it would not become truth. Again, pain, suffering, and fear swirled throughout his mind, all from attachment. These feelings latch on to Anakin, and this time, they give him no reprieve.
Premonitions? These visions you have.
They're of pain, suffering, death.
Yourself you speak of, or someone you know?
Someone.
Close to you?
Yes.
Eventually, it becomes clear that all of this truly stuck with him. Anakin needed to let go, but nobody told him how to do so. Even Yoda, wise Jedi Grandmaster, told him that he needed to let go of what he feared to lose. And in truth, that did nothing for him. Love and caring was something that Anakin thrived upon. We even see it in the Clone Wars in his bonds with Ahsoka Tano, even if that's a different type of love. So being told to let go just wasn't that easy for him, especially without the guidance on how to do so. But was this his fault? Was this the Jedi's fault for bringing him on to train so late in life? Was this the plan of the Force itself? Ask yourself those things as you examine this tragedy yourself, the tragedy that lived on into his time as a Dark Lord of the Sith, the tragedy that led to him becoming one in the first place, the tragedy of Anakin Skywalker.
Did you ever hear the tragedy of Darth Plagueis the Wise?
No.
I thought not. It's not a story the Jedi would tell you. It's a Sith legend.
The story is one we all know. Anakin Skywalker embraces the teachings of darkness after pure temptation. His son-to-father relationship with Chancellor Palpatine develops into an apprentice-to-master bond between Darth Vader and Darth Sidious, all on the promise of saving his wife from certain death, using techniques the Jedi would never have allowed Anakin to learn. Using the visions of Padme's death as bait, Palpatine lured Anakin to become his promised apprentice to enact the revenge of the Sith. But Anakin, he doesn't do this for selfish power, not the way he believes. Instead, he does this for her, for Padme, for his unborn children or child. If you watch the film, you can see the pain of making this choice painted all over Anakin's features, just before he kneels before the Dark Lord and swears himself to Sith teachings.
Become my apprentice. Learn to use the dark side of the Force.
I will do whatever you ask.
Good.
His attachments led him to a dark act once before, avenging the death of his mother. But now, to never lose anyone again, to save the one that he truly loves, he will do what he must, even if it means kneeling before the devil himself. Thus, with all of this, the tragedy of attachment and the suffering it brings lands a final blow on Anakin Skywalker, a blow that would dig until the day he died aboard the Death Star decades later.
Anakin, you're breaking my heart. You're going down a path I can't follow.
Because of Obi-Wan.
Because of what you've done. What you plan to do. Stop. Stop now. Come back. I love you.
Liar!
No!
You're with him. You brought him here to kill me.
No!
Let her go, Anakin. Let her go.
Now standing as Darth Vader, Anakin Skywalker would never let go of what happened on Mustafar. Beneath the mask, his mind dwelled upon Padme often, and all of his choices. All he did, all he put the galaxy through, just to save her, an attempt that ended up being fruitless. For his own anger and the trick of temptation that fell upon him, and the twist of the dark side, it all pushed Padme to death. It even pushed him to doubt Padme herself, to question her, for the first time ever. The teeth of everything that has brewed within Anakin for years had finally come to sink their teeth into his neck that day on Mustafar, and it was a successful blow they struck. Eventually becoming more machine than man, the imperious Dark Lord known as Vader would walk as a leader of the new Empire. But beyond and beneath all of that, was a man, one forced to live in absolute pain and absolute torment. Without love, without promise, knowing that everything he tried to save is what led him to this point, only for it to be all gone. Realizing that he has lost everything, and no matter what Anakin would do to try to change that, even as Vader all these years later, he would never be able to. Not until the fateful day, decades later, when the walking love of he and Padme came before him, Luke Skywalker, who helped prove to his father that there was, and always was, still good within him. This has been Dank Ferrick, and until the next time, remember that the Force will be with you, now and always.